Hey dwarves, a viewer left a comment in one of my videos asking me to play some unconventional builds, and they suggested Electrifying Reload. I had never really played this overclock before, but after playing it, it's not too bad. You don't know what the Electrifying Reload overclock is. It is an overclock for the GK2 assault rifle, and it is an unstable overclock. And what it does is if any bullets from a magazine damage an enemy's health bar, then those enemies will have an electrocute dot applied when that magazine gets reloaded. Electrocute does an average of 12 electric damage per second for 6 seconds. And then the debuffs are you get -2 direct damage and -5 magazine size. This is an unconventional overclock because it incentivizes you to reload often and really isn't about killing things as quickly as possible. I played with a lot of different builds with this, and I can't really decide on what is actually the best way to play this. It has a variety of different build paths that work. You can go a damage build path that is pretty similar in damage to some of the other overclocks, but, you know, still isn't as good as, for instance, overclock firing mechanism. Probably not as good as homebrew powder. Really, it might not be better than almost any of them for straight up normal damage, besides maybe AI stability engine, but you can most likely compensate for with getting a lot more headshots with AI stability engine. Even though it's not as high as some of the other ones, the damage still is okay and you can still kill grunts and such. You most likely won't be able to kill Praetorians as easily. Even going with the highest damage possible build for this build, it'll take you around 50 weak point shots to kill a Praetorian and around 61 to kill an Oppressor. So this build, regardless of how you build it, is really not for killing large creatures. If you go a full damage build, however, the DRG DPS calculator made by Meat Shield, and I'll link that in the description, puts the weak points shots on Glyphid Grunts at 2 shots. Now, when I was trying to test this, it was not as easy to get 2 headshots on things. I don't really understand exactly how it can be that, only two headshots, because the damage seems to be quite a bit lower. So I'm not sure if it's taking into effect the electrocute damage in this calculator or not, but it still is reliable in killing the smalls. So if you want to go a different build than the damage build, you can, and it's what I ran for a lot of my playtime with this. I didn't just do this 1 or 2 games. I played, you know, 15, 20 games of Electrifying Reload to figure out like what I liked about it, how to play with it effectively. I screwed around with a bunch of secondary options. I didn't really do any shotgun secondaries. We'll talk about that later, but there's a lot of Zhukov combinations you can do with this build. For instance, going 2, 2, 3, 2 or 3, and then 3 makes you a very supporty kind of character. With the high rate of fire, if you go both rate of fires and the large magazine capacity and more ammo, you can just use as much ammo as you can and just constantly reload to get as many electricity procs off you as you can. So normally what I would do is if I would see a horde coming, I would just shoot, just spray and pray all over the place just to hit as many of them as I could. And then that would have the whole wave slowed down and taking slight damage. It's an 80% slow electricity. So it is pretty massive if you can hit most of the shots. And with the high capacity magazine, you have 30. You go with the 20, that's still 20 grunts that you could slow down. Slowdown's really good to play with a team and staying close to them to provide as much. This is kind of like a driller build. You would use, this is like a sticky flame build or a driller that utilizes their ice paths a lot. You're similar to them in that respect. You're trying to help your team out by slowing everything down as much as possible. And then it's up to you whether or not if you want to switch to your secondary or just let your team mop everything up. This kind of allows the scout to be a super support in some ways. With the hardened rounds, if you go that, you could peel off Praetorian's armor for your teammates or just for yourself so you can get easier shots to get your electrocute off. And then if you use the stun in the last tier, you're going to be a powerhouse of CC for your team. You might think if you go the rate of fire build and you'll do absolutely no damage, that's not necessarily true. You could still kill Glyphid Grunts in 3 hits according to the calculator, 5 to their armor. That's not terrible with a 30 round clip and the high rate of fire, so you'll still be able to plow through grunts. Glyphid Guards, however, is about 10 shots to their weak points, but really those are kind of in the same tier as like Praetorians and Bulks for this build, as you're trying to slow those down in particular, not necessarily kill them. And this kills Slashers in 5 weak shots, so it's not terrible. It's not great, I would say. It's not great, but it is definitely doable. And if you have this as one of your OCs, and it's one of your few OCs you have at the moment, then give it a shot. It's really not bad. Either of the builds are fine. It just depends on what your team wants and what you want out of it. If you want a little bit of damage and then the electrifying reload is just kind of there for, you know, just an extra effect, then I would go with the damage build on this one, or a damage build. Now, if you really wanted to take extreme effect of the electrifying reload and really try to maximize it, then I would go the rate of fire plus a high capacity magazine choice. I'm gonna go over the builds real quick and make sure we know what they are. Now for damage, there's a couple different ways you can do damage. You can go 2, 1, 2, and anything in the third tier. However, if you go hollow point bullets, it doesn't really help you out as much as you might think it does. It only decreases the amount of shots in some of the enemies by like 2 or 1 in some cases. So really, it's not worth it. I wouldn't go hollow point bullets on this build because it's kind of unnecessary. So hardened rounds would probably be good. If you want to do a little damage, then you're probably going to want to be able to shoot grunt guards and Praetorians. So that is fine. Or you can go improved gas system to just pump out even more burst DPS with this build, which is totally fine. If you still wanted to go damage, but also have expanded a little bit more ammo, then I would go 2-1-2 anything in the third tier and then anything in the last tier. And the reason you don't need to go the second damage is because even with the third tier of damage, you're still able to kill Glyphid Grunts in 2 headshots, according to the calculator, that is. Now, if I was going to go a build that is focusing heavily on spreading around the proc of Electrocute and also have a lot of ammo and CC, then I would go with 2-2. And then in the third tier, you could go high capacity magazine, and you can also go improved propel. And the reason that is because with high capacity magazine, maybe that's too much to shoot before you reload. With a 20 round clip and with lots of the rate of fire increases going on, then you'll run out of real quick and you'll be reloading constantly. And so that would more quickly allow you to use your OC. But for the third tier, if you want to focus more on the electrocute part, then I would probably go 2-2, anything in the second tier, and then and depending on how supporty you want to go, say you want to be a complete support in every way, then a good really support build would be 2-2, anything in the third, and then hardened rounds, and then in the last tier, stun. This would be a huge CC build if you go this, and ability to help your team. With the hardened rounds, you may not kill the Praetorians, but you'll be able to shoot their armor off to help, you know, the NG hit them, help the gunner hit them from the front, all sorts of stuff. So this is kind of a support scout class, if anything. You'll still be able to kill lots of things, mainly because if you're using this effectively and using your grapple, and if you have, say, special powder, then you're untouchable. Nothing is ever going to catch you because of the electrocute. 80% slow, they're essentially stunned. They're never going to catch up to you. This build is especially good against things like bulks. If a bulk ever shows up and you're running this build, it doesn't even matter anymore. You can shoot it with one bullet and then reload. And using an animation cancel, you'll reload a little faster. But even if you mess it up, well, then you're still going to reload. And that's 6 seconds of 80% slow. So just every 6 seconds, you need to shoot it one time. Essentially, it's not moving. This helps your driller, say he's a cryo driller, to help you as well to slow it down. Or a sticky flame driller will help you make it impossible to move. You may not be doing a lot of damage, but this build, especially, and you can do this on Praetorians as well. If you see Praetorians going in groups, you can just fly behind them, shoot them a couple of times, and then reload, and then leave. And that way, your teammates aren't going to get hit by those Praetorians, and they can focus on the grunts, and then you can run back to your team to kill those grunts. It really works. This build is really interesting. It requires a very unique play style that really is, it can be fun if you want to try something new. All right, now that I've talked up electrifying reload a lot, let's maybe talk about why you wouldn't want to go this. Its damage is kind of low compared to overclocked firing mechanism and bullets of mercy and even homebrew. Really, any of them do more damage other than AI stability. They're all going to do more damage in this build. And so if that's really what you're focusing on, then I really wouldn't want to get this OC. It requires you to have to switch your weapons a lot, and so you're really involved with the game. So some people could say that's a good thing, and some could say it's bad, because you'll want to reload often and then maybe use a secondary to take effect of the electrifying reload. So it opens up you to use your secondary as a viable weapon, since they'll be slowed in taking damage. But at the same time, it's a little bit much sometimes, where I can use the overclock firing mechanism and just kill them very quickly because I'm just shooting a crap load of bullets, or bullets of mercy, since, you know, you're probably going to have a driller, or that's going to have, it's going to use his weapon occasionally, so you're most likely going to get the combo off. So with if you have bullets of mercy, then that's not as good either. AI Stability Engine is very nice because you can shoot and be extremely accurate from anywhere, and the weak point bonus is high, so you can headshot things very easily. Even gas rerouting and combat ammo are just all around good, and along with homebrew powder are just good. There's no real downsides, and they just add good things. Electrifying reload is definitely something that you have to really think about before you use. So, saying all those things, I would have to say this is definitely the worst of the GK2 overclocks. That being because most of them don't have really any downsides. AI stability does because it has a little bit less damage and a little slower rate of fire. But other than that, the other ones just give you bonuses. A rate of fire increase and a minus on reload time with gas rerouting, more ammo and less recoil with combat ammo. Homebrew powder, yeah, it's 0.8 damage to like times 1.4 damage per shot, but it averages to 1.1, and that's all according to the calculator. So usually it's just all around better. And then bullets of mercy, of course, you're most likely going to get a team unless you're playing solo. If you're playing solo, then you could also just use your IFG grenades or cryo grenades, and this will still be perfect. So it's still better. None of these are really terrible. Some of the classes have truly bad overclocks, like Snowball on the Driller is pretty terrible. A lot of the bouncing bullet ones seem kind of terrible. Yeah, they can work here and there, and then there are ways to make them viable. And I did just play a very fun style of gunner the other day that took in effect with those, but really it's not that great, and they're just kind of, you know, thrown in for funsies. But really, none of them are truly terrible, unlike some of those. The Scout's Electrifying Reload is still good. It still works. If this is the only one you have, for instance, or if it's on your list to buy, totally consider getting it. It's a fun playstyle, and maybe you'll like the huge amount of utility that you get with this. You'll be slowing everything. It is very nice. If you can effectively use the Electrifying Reload, then you can make the game a lot easier for your teammates and yourself. All right, saying this, this is going on a lot longer than I thought it would, but that's okay, I guess. The next thing we'll talk about is that we can talk about a little bit on the sidearms that you might want to take with this. Mainly, I'm going to focus on Zhukovs, because if I want to go unconventional, then for me, unconventional is Zhukovs with the Scouts. Scout pretty much is perfect if you have special powder attached to it, I think. The other way to play it is very lacking, I feel. Without the crazy mobility that it gets, it's just so fun. It may not be the best or do mad DPS, but I don't really care. I just love flying around and doing all sorts of crazy crap, and it's just fun. So if I'm going fun, then special powder is way better, and just for general usefulness, special powder is way better than anything the Zhukovs have. And especially with damage, the shotgun itself does a lot of damage. Regardless of any of the builds you take, even special powder at close range will kill grunts instantly. So it's really not that big of a deal to me to use it as a weapon as well. So if you're running any of the builds on the shotgun, it's probably going to work. Taking advantage of maybe some large spread would be fine, because they're going to be in packed groups with the Electrify, and then you'll be able to just destroy them. So some blow-through rounds are always advised with any of the builds. With Zhukovs, there's like three separate builds that I think you could run that make it pretty easy. You can run a damage kind of build, and that would be with gas recycling, minimal magazines, or custom casings. You would run a damage heavy build with and go maybe 2-1-1-1 all the way down, 2 and then all ones. And you would probably do that because since they're all gonna be electrocuted, you're going to get effectiveness from the last mod to 30% direct damage dealt to enemies either being electrocuted or from the IFG grenade. So once they're all electrocuted, you pull these out and you're going to slice through some of them. Now on Has-5, you're not really doing a whole lot of damage. So that can be a problem with going this, but it still works. These are still a viable build to do this. And you want the blow-through rounds because they're going to be in a line most likely, because if you're running this, you're probably going to be fighting things kind of on the ground a little bit more. If you're playing with your team, that is. So you'll be able to stick with your team and kill things with this kind of build. You could really run anything you want, but I would prefer to have blow-through rounds and probably conducted bullets. And if I'm gonna run these, I'd probably want a little bit of damage because the main gun is a little lacking on damage. Now, the next build that I would talk about with a Zhukov would be the Embedded Detonators. Really, really powerful. I would also want blow-through on that. And you don't necessarily have to go with damage, I don't believe. I think you can just go ammo and supercharged feed mechanism if you want, or any of the ammo mods. And then the third tier, you could go base spread to make sure you're hitting everything. But you definitely want the blowthrough rounds, because once they're all electrocuted, they're gonna be slowed. And then the blowthrough rounds will allow you to hit everything in the wave with as many embedded detonators as you can, allowing you to really blow up hordes. It can be really good, and this can be how you get your burst damage in this build, just by running embedded detonators. And use this on the larger enemies, and it will help you a lot that if you're having problems, and you don't necessarily have to run conductive bullets on embedded detonators either. You could run the get in, get out, and it would be fine. For the last build you can run, this is kind of a really fun thing that I did when I first started switching over to this. I ran cryo minelets. And you could run a lot of damage with this, or you could run a lot of ammo, but I wouldn't focus on doing damage with this build. This is really, if you're going true support, and you're going like the other build that focuses on the utility of the electrifying reload, and you really want to be all support all the time, cryo mindless is the way to go, but you're not going to be shooting at people. So I would go with one or two, and then three with the recoil bonus, and then I would do expanded ammo bags even, and then get in, get out. And the reason for that is you're just gonna be shooting at the ground with this. You're not trying to do anything but shoot at the ground. While you're shooting on the ground, you just wait a second. So really you're shooting in front of everything that's coming at you. This even works on things like dreadnoughts and bulks. This is really a good way to, if you are running the utility build, you're not gonna be able to damage Praetorians and stuff. So if you're electrocuting them and then freezing them, you're just all around useful to your team. This is a really supporty build, and it's really fun, admittedly. I was having a lot of fun, because you can endlessly kite with this build as well. Nothing will be able to catch you, and in case you went the damage build, you could also run this as well, and take advantage of the freeze effect constantly with the damage that you're running. So it's really up to you, but I feel like if you're doing that, then it kind of takes away the point of running electrifying reload. But it's anything you want. Those three are the main ones I would talk about if I was going to run a secondary. Any of them are good. It just depends on what you want to play. And really, this is how you kind of complete the class. The support scout in this would be completed with a damage secondary, or with the damage and gas recycling and such, or embedded detonators. And then, or you can go all out support with the cryo. Now, when we're at the grenades, that's where it can get to be very personal. I generally do not like to get rid of cryos, and I still mostly didn't with this. It didn't seem to really go well with the build, but it helps your team. So it's really whatever you feel is better. If you're going all in the build, maybe the best one is IFG or even pheromones, really. Because if you could run pheromones, and then you could shoot them before electrocuting them into pheromones, they'll kill themselves with that. They'll kill each other, and the electrocute will kill them. So they'll just kill them each other. That is a very decent build that could run. I have a friend that I played with the other day that ran pheromones a lot when he was playing scout, and it kind of worked. So with the electrifying reload, it could also work, and they could kill each other with the electrocute and each other at the same time. So try it out. That could totally work. IFGs are also good just for the support play style, as you'll be able to throw them around your team or multiple in a row to stop large hordes, and your team must be able to mop up. You can run any kind of perks you want this. It doesn't really matter. You could consider using Vampire with this as well, with a scout. Normally, I don't run it with scout, but you totally could, because enemies are often going to be low health. So you'll be able to get kills with your auto attacks quite often. You may not even have to use power attacks to pull it off either. All right, everybody, I really appreciate you sticking through. And thank you to all the subscribers and stuff that we've had recently. It's been pretty crazy. My buddy Deb, who runs the channel with me, has been on vacation for a while. And he'll come back eventually. But for now, I've been deciding to do these Deep Rock videos. And it's really been a lot of growth for our channel, and it's been really cool. We really appreciate like all the likes, all the great comments you guys have had. And all the subs, I mean, it's been pretty great. We went from like 14 subs to, at the time of this, it's like 206 or something like that. I mean, we thought it was gonna be years before we had any kind of anything, really. And it's kind of happening, you know. We're not PewDiePie or anything, but I mean, it's cool. It's really cool that so many of you have enjoyed these videos and that they're helping anybody. I ran into somebody during one of my games the other day. I was like a brand new player, and he said that he liked my videos, and I thought that was the coolest thing. I kind of assumed that a lot of people that would be playing this would be that would be watching this would be veterans, because it's all has five, but it seems like new people watch it too, and I think it's really cool. If you're new and you have other questions about the game and you think that there's something lacking, maybe in the tutorial or something, you know, give me a suggestion for a video or something like that, and I'll think about what I can do with that. As you see, in one of my other videos, I take comments and then I run with it and then I do videos on it. So if you enjoyed this video and you want to see your comment posted or anything like that, just, you know, give me a comment, give me an idea. And if I choose yours, it'll show up in the next video. You know, I appreciate all of you dwarves watching and liking and all that stuff, like I said. And I'll see you guys next time. Thanks a lot. Bye.